Hello, everybody. Nice to meet you and nice to being here. I hope you can hear me now. And yeah, thank you for the great welcome. And today, what Robert said, I want to talk about inheritance and object composition and how to reusing code in Angular. And what Robert said, I completed my education as a mathematical technical software developer, and I'm an employee at Energy to Market. And yeah, today we code a little bit sustainably. So first of all, here's a little agenda. We talk about the purpose of code reuse. After that, I explain inheritance and object composition. I talk about the relationship between these principles and code reuse. I talk a little bit what to prefer. And after that, we see some nice examples in Angular. And after that, we got a little conclusion. So at first, we start with the purpose. These days, for our applications, decoupled and encapsulated software system is ever more relevant because the software projects are getting bigger and bigger. The code will be more complex. We got many frameworks, many good ideas spread the world. So reusability, maintenance care, and sustainability play a major role in our software project and in our software systems. And experienced engineers prefer a decoupled and encapsulated software system because we got so many code in our project, so many models, so many classes, so interfaces, components. We need to decouple and decouple them and reuse the code to get the system a little bit smaller. And to build such systems are very expensive and need a lot of time. And when we reusing our code, we can spend not a lot of money and spend not a lot of time. And these days, tests are getting more important, end-to-end tests, unit tests. And when you change your code and expand your code, there is a risk that you change your unit tests. So you need to spend double time for implement a feature and implement the unit tests and the end-to-end tests. And when you reuse your code and being smart, you can spend not so much of time. And when you overthink the principles, how you can reuse your code sustainably, then you know that when you change some modules or when you change some classes, then you need to modify your unit tests or you need to modify your end-to-end tests or need to modify other classes who are in a relationship with the changed class. And when you overthink it, it's better when you're using the open close principle to don't change your classes, but extend these classes. So the open-close principle says software entities, components, classes, modules should be open for extension, but closed for modification. So you can extend your classes, your modules, but you don't modify this. When you modify this, you need to change your unit tests, you need to change other classes. And so you don't reuse your code effectively. Sorry. So the first principle to reusing your code is the principle of inheritance. So what is inheritance? Inheritance is a relationship. You see on the right, we got a base class, a creature class, who is a base class. We got some base methods, some base properties, and we got a speedsolite model below. That's the human class. That's a super class who inherit fields and methods and properties from the creature class and is specialized. And below we got a construction worker who inherits fields and properties and methods of human and fields and properties and methods of the creature. So we got a relationship between three classes, the creature class, human class, and the construction class. So that's a little example what inheritance is. And what I said, a subclass is a specialized model of a generalized base class. The creature is the base class, the human is a specialized creature. We got arms, we got a head, we got a leg, we got a stomach, and so on. And yeah, and what I said too, a subclass inherits fields, methods from their base class and superclass. But not all fields or methods are inherited. You can change this behavior with the visibility with private, protected, public, and you can may override these in your subclasses. Inheritance is one of the most famous core concept of object-oriented programming, and it's very uncomplicated and very easy to handle. And yeah, I think these days every programmer know inheritance. Yeah, and inheritance is will be defined in design time. A little example. We got a creature and we got a relationship to a human, and this relationship is tightly coupled. So it's defined in the class constructor, in the design time constructor. And I can't unlink this relationship in my runtime. I can't say in my runtime, human is no creature anymore. That's not possible. So this concept, when you overthink this, is a tightly coupled relationship, because every member of this relationship knows many things about the other class. So the Gang of Four, the writer of design patterns, said that inheritance is a white box reuse. It says internals of a base class are visible to their subclasses. A little bit example, when I got two constructor in my creature class and in my human class, and when I create my human and I call a super class in my constructor and I jump into the creature class, I see everything about this constructor of the creature class. All these informations are known by the subclass, and the more these classes are known from the other, the more tightly coupled are they. And this tightly, and this relationship is very affected by modifications. For example, when I modificate my constructor of my creature class, it will automatically affected my class of the human. So when I said my creature class, my creature is 2 meters high, my human is in a constructor automatically 2 meters too. It's a directly modification, and this relationship breaks up the encapsulation. And you will get many code risks by changing your subclasses. Your tests you wrote for your subclasses can be affected by these risks. So inheritance is a very tightly coupled relationship, but it is very easy to use. reuse your code, because you can reuse the code of your base class and your superclass. Overthink this, because you can use everything of your base class, but there are many risks why you can reuse it. And you can prevent this or avoid this by using abstract classes as a base class. In abstract classes, you only declare the name of the method or the name of the property. And you need to implement these methods in your superclass. And the most important thing about inheritance in Qt reuse is this white box reuse principle and the very tightly coupled relationship. Another technique about Qt reusing is object composition. Easily said, object composition is a has a relationship. We got two examples on the right. The first example at the top is a very simple example. It's a relationship between a concrete class, car, and concrete classes, wheels, engine, and windows. A short explanation: a car got mostly four wheels, and these wheels are separated classes with implementation of size, of a method to roll. We got some engines, we got a diesel engine or a petrol engine, and we got windows who got some properties about the color, and we got technical stuff like radio. So this is one kind of object composition, and there are a second kind of object composition in the right corner below. There we got a car with wheels, with engine and windows, but we got a relationship to a concrete class. We got a relationship to an abstract class. So in my car, I can say my wheels are typed by abstract wheel. My engine is typed by abstract engine. My window is typed by abstract window. And nobody knows at design time how the wheel or how the engine is implement directly. We only know the interfaces. We only know the name of the method. We only know the name of the properties or of the fields. And behind that, we can say at design time, we can fill these with concrete classes. I can implement a rim or a bike wheel with these interfaces, and I connect the car object and the concrete classes with dependency inversion at design time. So easily said, it's a really dynamically method to using reuse code, because I got separated concrete classes on right. We got a rim, we got a bike wheel, we got a abstract engine like diesel and petrol, and I got an abstract decoration of a car who got wheels and engine and so on. And I can switch at design time my implementations. I can say at design time, okay, I got a car. The car should have wheels like a rim. Or I got next step. I can say my wheels should be a bike wheel. That's not possible with inheritance. With inheritance, I can say at design time, my car got a rim implementation, or my car got a bike wheel implementation. So easily said. Object composition is an assignment of a reference to other objects. You can use this with interfaces or you can not. When you use it with interfaces, it's called a dependency inversion. Object composition is fundamental to every programming language, not only in object-oriented programming. What I say, you can change your assignments at runtime very easily and very dynamically. And what I said too, you can reuse your code, your implementation, you can reuse your implementations and ever reference very easily. And the opposite of inheritance is that object composition is a black box reuse. You can't see the internals of the implementation of the objects. You only see the interfaces. You only see the named method. You only see the name of the properties or the fields. You can't see the implementation. You only can use the implementation in design time. So that's called a very loosely coupled module with a nice encapsulation, because design time, you got a car class here, you got a abstract engine called diesel petrol there, and there are no relationship. First, when you start your application, your software project, there are a relationship together. And you can change your components or your objects without any code risks, because you don't know the internals. They are not directly affected by changing. And so object composition is a very loosely coupled principle. So what's the difference? Or rather, which concept we should prefer, object composition or inheritance? But I said, but I have to say, both got strengths and weakness, because there are different problems to use object composition and inheritance, because that depends on your problem. The most UI frameworks are using inheritance, because you got a base component with base properties, base methods, very generalized. And when you go high the tree, there are some components you get specialized. You got, for example, you got a box. It's base class, and the specialized model is a mad card like Google from Google. A mad card is stylish. Is got many methods to handle some user inputs, and so on. And that's inheritance. But other principles are using object composition more. Example is here the design patterns concept. There are more object compositions design patterns like Abstract Factory, who are a very cool principle to create new objects. And the core concept of these are object compositions. And the Gang of Four, the writer, Richard Gemmer, Erich Gemmer, Richard Helm, Ralph Johnson, and John Weisitz write in their book that we should prefer composition over inheritance whenever we can. Because with composition, you got this decoupled and encapsulated software system, and you can test your software system better than with inheritance. Because with inheritance, you got the direct relationship. When you modify something in the base class, you modify some other things in your your subclass. And yeah, but what I said before, it's preference. Depends on your problem, what you want to solve. So let's switch to some Angular examples how to reuse code in Angular. To stop this. So we start with inheritance. A common issue is to reuse your code when you subscribe some observables of, for example, an NGRX store. I got a simple example. We got two components, and both components consume a random number, which is stored in my store. And when I press it, both components consume these. And I will show you my implementation. We got a store. Got a read user here, and in the store I got a state with a number who's in its slide with -1, and here a number, here's initialization -1, here's my number, and when I press the button I will raise a side effect who calls the service, who generates a new random number. You see here MarfFloor and MarfRandom, and both components will consume this side effect because both components extends a base class. And in the base class, I got a subscription, I got my observable, and I consume my select number, also my state of my random number of the store. When I don't use this base class, I need to implement those subscription in my subcomponent one and in my subcomponent two, and I don't want be dry. Also I repeat myself in both components, the subscription of the state. So inheritance is a nice best practice for subscribe to some store properties. And yeah, in my next example, we're using composition and services. But first of all, I show you the example. We got two components again. And we got a theme component, a dark theme component, and a light theme component. And yeah, they consume a service who said what they have to do, to be light or have to be dark. So the core model of this example is my abstract class of the abstract team. The abstract class implemented a get font name and a get style name and abstract. And I got my two components who implement a service, who implement the abstract team service. And I said, okay, here in my light team service, I want a Comic Sans MS font when I call the function. And I want to return the style name when I call this get style name method.
Patrick, sorry to interrupt you. Can you please increase the font size a bit in your
yes,
editor?
Of course. Okay, sorry. Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Again, I got abstract team service with two abstract methods. I got implementation, a concrete implementation of the abstract team service with font name and get style name. The same with my dark team service. And yeah, now we will come to the magic. We got a component, a light team component. And you see, I got implementation, as I inject the abstract team service and call the abstract functions. And the same I do at a dark team component, and it's exactly the same. When I zoom a little bit more, you see I need to zoom a little bit. It's exactly the same implementation. So when you overthink, we want to be dry, I can create a base component. I can put this implementation into my base component and call the ng on it with my super function. And yeah, the only difference is this thing at the top. I got a provider who use a dependency inversion. I got an extract team service. That's the thing I showed before. And I say with this little bit of code that when something calls the abstract team service, it should be injected with the light team service. And the same thing will happen here. Here I say when something in these when someone calls this component, it will inject with the dark team service. So when we see the example, we got a dark team component who calls the method and gets the font Arial and the style dark. When we look in our HTML, we consume the font and the style. And this is set here. And here we only call the abstract method. And the magic is that we use a dependency inversion and inject the abstract service with our dark team service. So you can reuse this thing of code. You can reuse the services again. And when you add a team component, one more team component, maybe a custom theme component or a blue theme component, you only need to create a new style. You only need to create a component and inherit this from your base class, and you are done. You need to use dependency inversion to set abstract team class with your new team class, and yeah, you are fine. You don't need to change your implemented code. You extend your code with a new theme component and a new theme service. Yeah, and that's really cool. That's really nice. And that's one cool thing of Angular to using composition. Yeah, we got a next example. Can I zoom here into two? No. I show it in the browser. It's an example with object composition and observables. I got a supermarket component where I can add some ice cream, pizza, or juice in my cart. When I press these buttons, you see my cart get ice cream with a price of 1.3 euro. And when I add some pizza, I can call some console logs and add it to the cart. And with juice, the same. And I can clear the cart very easily too. So how I implement this, the core concept is again abstract class and interface. I implement a get name function, a get price function, and a get rate functions. And I implemented some concrete classes. We've got ice cream here who implements the interface. I filled the methods. I got the juice here who implements the iProduct. And I got some pizza model who implements the product and got some custom filled methods too. So that's the core concept, like in the example before. And I got a service who handle all these products. I got a subject here. I got a subject of my iProduct, of my my interface. I got a method who I can filter the object. And I got a function who consumed the object, and both as observables. And I got a function who clear the subject. And yeah, the one thing of magic is my supermarket class. I got a method where I can put something into my cart, service, what we see before. I got a parameter of iProduct. And when we switch here, we come into our service where we fill the subject. And the magic is here. I create a concrete object of the iProduct and put it into my subject. I create an ice cream, I create a pizza, I create a juice. And my cart is here to consume all this. I got here my cart component. What we see in the inheritance example, I got a subscription, I got a destroyer, and I subscribe on the observable to get all my cart my supermarket products from the service. So I subscribed it, and every time when someone the supermarket put it in the subject, we consume it here and push it into our iProduct array. So what happens in the view? I got a simple ng4 method to show the product we get in the front end, and these products we get are a concrete object at design time. So we get a pizza, we get a juice, or we get ice cream as concrete objects to design time, and we can give the user a nice feeling about this supermarket. Yeah, and the thing to reuse your code is that you, when you add new products to a supermarket, you don't need to change your cart. Your cart is done. You don't need to change anything here. Your card service is done. You don't need to change anything here because you use object composition. You use the interfaces to put informations from one side of the software application to the other side. And when you add some nice vegetables, models, objects, you only need to create a new class who implements the iProduct, and you only need to modify the supermarket component with a new method to create a concrete object of vegetables, and you need to modify your model. And that's all. That's code reusing with observables. Your card is every time the same. Your card service is every time the same. You need only to add a new model, and you only extend your supermarket component with a new method. Yeah. The next thing is composition and decorators. I choose the decorator input. The example of the of this, we got we got a little ice cream snack bar, and the main component fills the cart. So that's cart. My UX is not the best, but fills the cart with some informations. And when we dive into the code, the core concept is again an interface. Abstract class who got a get price method, who got a get type method, who got a get carries method, and we got some concrete classes. We got a vanilla class who implements the interface. We got a strawberry class who implements the interface, and so on. And we got an imbiss component, a snack bar component, who creates the concrete objects of our models with, and they are called by these methods: get vanilla, get strawberry, and get stracciatella. And when we dive into our view, we see we call some other component who got a decorator of ice. So when we dive into the separated component, we will see an input. An input decorator with eyes who are typed by the interface. Here is linked by the interface, and only what we see in the view is that we call the abstract methods of this interface, but with object composition and design time, we will get the concrete objects of stracciatella, strawberry, and vanilla. So when you reuse code here, you don't need to change your ice card component because they implement the interfaces. You don't need to change, you need to modify your imbiss component. You need to add a new method to create a chocolate ice, for example, and you need to create a new model of chocolate. So you reuse the code in your ice card component, and you don't need to change that anything. And yeah, we got a nice example with composition in services. The core concept is again an interface who is got a method to paint something, and we got some concrete object, concrete classes who implements the interface and implements the method. We got a color interface here who can paint. We got some concrete classes of purple, red, and yellow who implements the method and returns some string calls themselves. Yeah, and we got a service who implements a method, who got a interface of color as parameter and calls the paint function. So what we do in our palette, color palette, is we create some concrete objects and link that with our private field of typed color or of the interfaces. And after that, we call our service and give the service our concrete object as parameter. So when we see the practice, the example here, we can use red and then we can paint. Oh, sorry, we changed some code. Angular is compiling. So we can use red and we will see here in the console that we paint red. We can use purple and we see we paint purple. We can use yellow and so on. And when you want to see the code reuse aspect here is when you want to add one more color, maybe black or white, you don't need to change your service because the service wanna have an interface as parameter, and you only need to modify your palette component. You need to add a new method to use black or use white, and that's all. And you need to add your your class who implements the color. And yeah, that's code reusing of with object composition and inheritance in Angular. I think the most viable, thing I used is this one, where you can inject your services with concrete service. And yeah, I think the most frameworks, when you use them, you need to use these concepts in your app, in your app module to set the abstract interfaces with concrete interfaces. For example, Apollo is some of these frameworks. You need to set a translation module. NGX Translate is one of these frameworks where you need to use this concept, because you need to set your default translation in your app module. So what's the conclusion of code reusing object composition and inheritance? The conclusion is that you overthink your behavior, how you code your software products or your software applications, because it's very important to build your software system in a very easily maintainable way, because you are not the only developer in lifetime, I think, who see your code, because when you create some applications, they overlive you. And there are our developers who need to read your code and need to modify your code and maintain your code. So yeah, it's very important. So, and you need to design your software systems more loosely coupled. And that's a hint to using some object composition more. I can say something about me. When I finished to read the book Design Patterns, I've overthink my behavior, and since then I use object composition very, very often. And yeah, we need to try to be dry. We don't need to repeat our code. We need to reuse our code, and inheritance and object composition are very nicely principles. Object composition is a concept to use your code more flexibility, because you got this runtime behavior. You can change this runtime behavior. But inheritance is a better a node principle and a very easy to handle principle. You can combine. You can use a combination of both. You can combine object orientation with inheritance. And yeah, what I said, Design Patterns is a really cool, book. I would like when you read it, because it's make a lot of fun. I take a lot off with me because of the book. And yeah, that's are my references. What I said, Design Patterns. I've been a really, really big fan of clean code and clean architecture. Robert C. Martin write a lot of code reusing about decoupled systems and so on. And it's take a look. So thank you. I hope you enjoyed this. I'm a little bit excited. I hope it was not too confusing, and happy coding for future.